Hi there and welcome back. Let's review Swainson-Goldberg syndrome, SGS. We'll get into the causes, signs, symptoms or characteristics, statistics, diagnosis, treatment and bottom line underwriting. SGS is a connective tissue disorder that affects many parts of the body. People who have this syndrome have a combination of unique facial features and skeletal and neurological abnormalities. SGS is also referred to as Marfanoid Craniosynostosis Syndrome and Swainson-Goldberg Craniosynostosis Syndrome. In different literature, you will find different nomenclature. Causes. SGS is often caused by defects or mutations in the SKI gene. This gene provides instructions for making a protein that controls the transforming growth factor beta TGFB signaling pathway. The TGFB signaling pathway regulates many processes, including proliferation, that is cell growth and division, differentiation, that is the process by which cells mature to carry out special functions, mobility, that is cell movement, apoptosis, that is the self-destruction of cells. The SKI protein is found in many cell types throughout the body and appears to play a role in the development of many tissues, including the skull, other bones, skin, and brain. In SGS, the SKI gene mutation prevents the TGFB signaling pathway from carrying out its many functions in these areas. So, what are the signs and symptoms or the characteristics? SGS shares many features with Marfan syndrome, including long arms, legs, and fingers, curved spine. In SGS, the skull bones fuse or join together too early, preventing the skull from growing normally. Facial features that result may include a long, narrow head, abnormal head shape, widely spaced eyes, wandering eye, outside corners of the eyes that point downward, low set ears that are rotated backward, high narrow roof of the mouth, underdeveloped jaw bones, unusually large range of joint movement or joint hypermobility, one or more fingers that are permanently bent, weak muscle tone in infancy, heart or brain abnormalities. SGS also shares many features with LDS, the Lewis Dietz syndrome, including all of the typical craniofacial and skeletal findings. In addition, people with SGS often have delayed development and mild to moderate intellectual disability or neurologic anomalies. This is rarely seen in LDS or Lewis Dietz syndrome, and it is not associated at all with Marfan syndrome. So, what about the statistics? SGS is an extremely rare disorder, but the exact prevalence is unknown. Fewer than 50 cases of SGS have been reported to date worldwide. How do we diagnose SGS? The diagnosis of SGS is made after a thorough examination and the identification of certain craniofacial, skeletal, cardiovascular, neurologic features and brain anomalies. A gene test is available to test for a change in the SKI gene, the one gene known to date to cause this syndrome. However, a person can have SGS and may not test positive for the SKI gene. Okay. Treatment includes psychotherapy to increase mobility, actually physiotherapy to increase mobility for those with joint contracture. Orthopedic devices may be required for scoliosis or other bone problems, surgical repair of abdominal hernias, surgical correction of craniofacial or chest problems are sometimes necessary or desirable. Shunting may be required for patients with hydrocephalus. If you recall, we have discussed hydrocephalus, water on the brain, in one of the prior sessions that we have reviewed. So basically what happens here is a surgical placement of a shunt to drain the accumulated fluid in the brain to abdominal cavity to relieve the pressure. Then genetic counseling is recommended for families and individuals who have been diagnosed with SGS. Anyone with SGS should be managed by a cardiologist who is familiar with the condition. So how do we underwrite? As far as underwriting goes, follow your underwriting manual and company specifics that your company expects you to follow. Okay, let's take a break here. See you soon. Take care. Bye now.